Welcome to this quick guide where I'm going to show you how to password protect your Outlook on Windows 10 and Windows 11. And if you get any value out of this video, please click the like button and subscribe to the channel. But to get started with the guide, if you want to password protect your Outlook on your computer, you can start by doing a search for the control panel and then open up the control panel app. Then here in the control panel, just change this view by setting to small or large icons. And then you want to find the mail, Microsoft Outlook, and then click on that. Then you'll get this window. And here you need to click on data files. And then once it's launched here in the data files, you'll need to have a look at these files. And specifically, you need to check if you have a file here that ends in .pst. As you can see here, I've got two files that end in .pst and the other two end in .ost. If you want to put a password on your Outlook, you need to have a .pst file. If you don't have a single .pst file here, just click on Add. Then just give this file a name. You can just call it Outlook or whatever. It doesn't really matter. You can just give it a name and then click on OK. And it's going to add that file as a .pst file. Then you need to select any one of those .pst files. For this tutorial, I'm just going to select the one that I just created. Then click on Settings. And then in this window, you'll have this option that says change password. So you can click on that and then you can add a password. First, you'll need to enter the old password. Now, obviously, you don't have an old password yet, so just leave that blank. Then type in the new password. And then type in the new password again in the verify password field. And lastly, you'll have this option that says save this password in your password list. If you select this option, you won't be prompted to enter the password, which kind of defeats the purpose of having a password on Outlook. Except if someone else gets these files and they try and access it on their Outlook, then they'll need the password before they can access it. But for this tutorial, we're just trying to put a password on our Outlook, so when someone opens it on our computer, they won't be able to get access to it. So I'm just going to leave that unchecked and then click on OK. Then click on OK again. Now, another important thing that you need to do is you need to make this Outlook file that you put the password on as the default data file. So select it and then click on Set as Default. You'll see this prompt. Just click on Yes and you'll be prompted to enter that password. Just enter it and click on OK. And you'll see this checkmark icon should now be on that .pst file that you put the password on. Once you've done that, you can close and exit out of all these windows. And then open Outlook on your computer. Then you'll be prompted to enter that password before you can view anything in Outlook. So I'll just enter the password and then click on OK. And only then I'll have access to Outlook. And you're going to need to enter that password every single time that you launch Outlook. Now you'll see here that your default data file will be on top. So you'll have this new data file in Outlook, which won't have any info in it. So you can just click on that icon to minimize it. And then you can go ahead and use the other folders here on your computer. Now, if you want to get rid of the password, you can follow the same steps by going to the control panel, then going to mail, data files. Then you just want to select that file again, click on settings, enter the password that you have set up, click on OK, click on change password. And then in the field where it says old password, type in your current password. And then for the new password, just leave it blank because you want to get rid of the password. Then click on OK. Click on OK again. And now if you open Outlook, you won't be prompted to enter the password again. So I hope this guide's been useful. Please like the video and I'll see you in the next one.